Yeah, I think just the main thing you want to do is if you need to extend and sort of spend some money you wouldn't plan on spending, just make sure you have a plan to pay for it all, whether you cash flow it, whether you dip into your savings or your emergency fund to do that if you have one, or if you do buy something minimally on a credit card, have a plan to pay it off. Don't just go zipping a whole bunch of charges on there and saying, hey, it's for my kids, and turn around, you know, 30 days from now and have a $1,500 hole drilled in your credit card. That's just not the way to go about it. So don't use the quote unquote emergency situation as an excuse to spend money that you don't have. Yeah, it's easy to do here, right? Because you're doing this for your kids. You're like, oh, I really need this for my kids, but you know, try to figure. And look, I'm handy, and this is the example that I use. I'm handy, so I understand that some people are not. But I mentioned this before. I run around and I grab pallets from garbage dumpsters. It's free wood, right? And I bring it home and I pull all the nails out of it and I cut it down and I make these little backyard obstacles, these little ninja courses that you see on YouTube. Just Google kids ninja course. You'll come up with a gajillion videos. And you can build these little obstacle courses and the kids can help you. All you need is the free wood, a box of screws and a drill and maybe a saw to cut it, you know, into the shapes you need. And then you can go out with your kids, you can buy a quart of paint, you know, for $6 or $10 or whatever it costs you, and they can paint the thing there, whatever color they want. You can put all this stuff around the backyard and boom, you're off to the races. I built a teeter totter year before. It was basically like, it was a little platform with a long board. I did have to go out and buy the long board at you know, the hardware store because we couldn't find the long board that you needed. It's like, you know, it's like an 8 foot, 10 foot board. But it's basically like a teeter totter, but instead of sitting on it and, you know, going, you know, back like a seesaw up and down, it's meant to run up the one side. It flips, you know, the weight flips and then you run down the other side. And then you can pull that long board off, and it's just an obstacle that you can jump over. So it kind of does double duty. But I want to build a few more of those minus the teeter totter piece to make some more obstacle type of things. And we'll paint it all crazy colors. We'll paint it blue and pink and red and whatever the heck they want to paint it.